The menstrual cycle is a natural, monthly occurrence in a woman's life. It is a complex process regulated by hormones and plays a crucial role in reproductive health. It typically lasts around 28 days, although it can vary from person to person. In this video, we will explore the details of the menstrual cycle, including its phases, the hormones at play, bodily changes, common concerns, and factors influencing it. The cycle is divided into four main phases: the menstrual phase, the follicular phase, the ovulation phase, and the luteal phase. The menstrual phase, also known as menstruation or the period, is the first stage of the menstrual cycle, a cyclical process that occurs in the female reproductive system. This phase begins when an egg from the previous cycle isn't fertilized. It typically lasts for about 3 to 7 days, although the duration can vary from woman to woman. The menstrual phase begins with a drop in the levels of two key hormones, estrogen and progesterone. These hormones play crucial roles in regulating the menstrual cycle. The fluctuations in their levels triggers the release of another hormone called prostaglandin, which is responsible for causing uterine contractions. As prostaglandin levels rise, the uterine muscles start contracting. These contractions are necessary to help expel the old uterine lining that has built up in preparation for a potential pregnancy during the previous cycle. The contractions can vary in intensity and can cause discomfort or cramping in some women. The shedding of the uterine lining results in the flow of blood and tissue from the vagina. This menstrual flow typically starts off heavy and gradually becomes lighter over the course of the menstrual phase. The color of menstrual blood can vary from bright red to brownish red, depending on how quickly it leaves the body. The typical volume of blood loss during menstruation is approximately 30 milliliters to 40 milliliters. Any amount greater than 80 milliliters is considered abnormal. Many women experience various physical and emotional symptoms during the menstrual phase. Common symptoms include abdominal cramps, lower back pain, breast tenderness, bloating, fatigue, mood swings, and irritability. The follicular phase begins right after menstruation ends. Typically, it starts on the first day when period occurs and ends when ovulation occurs. This phase normally lasts for about 12 to 16 days, although the duration can vary among individuals. The follicular phase is initiated by a rise in the hormone known as follicle-stimulating hormone produced by the pituitary gland. Follicle-stimulating hormone stimulates the growth of several small sac-like structures called follicles in the ovaries. Each follicle contains an immature egg or oocyte. Typically, one dominant follicle emerges and continues to grow, while the others regress. This dominant follicle will eventually release an egg during ovulation. As the dominant follicle grows, it produces increasing amounts of the hormone estrogen. Estrogen plays a pivotal role in preparing the uterine lining for potential pregnancy. It promotes the thickening and vascularization of the endometrial tissue. Some women may experience physical symptoms during the follicular phase, including mild pelvic discomfort or a sense of fullness in the lower abdomen. These sensations are usually associated with the growing follicles, but are generally not severe. The ovulation phase, also known as the mid-cycle phase, is a crucial stage in the menstrual cycle. It occurs approximately in the middle of a woman's menstrual cycle, typically around day 14 in a 28-day cycle. During this phase, the mature follicle in the ovary releases an egg, or ovum, into the fallopian tube. Ovulation is a key event in a woman's reproductive cycle, as it is the period when conception is most likely to occur. The primary hormone responsible for triggering ovulation is luteinizing hormone, which surges in response to rising estrogen levels during the follicular phase. This surge of luteinizing hormone triggers the final maturation of the dominant follicle and prompts it to release the egg. Ovulation is the process by which the mature follicle ruptures, expelling the egg from the ovary into the fallopian tube. The egg is then available for fertilization by sperm, should they be present in the reproductive tract. The ovulation phase is considered the most fertile time in a woman's menstrual cycle. It is the window of opportunity for conception. Sperm can survive for several days in the female reproductive tract, so having intercourse days before ovulation can also result in pregnancy. Some women experience physical symptoms during ovulation, including mild pelvic pain or a sensation of fullness on one side of the lower abdomen. This discomfort is known as Mittelschmerz and is associated with the release of the egg. Leading up to and during ovulation, there is often a noticeable change in the consistency and appearance of cervical mucus. It becomes clear, slippery, and stretchy, resembling raw egg whites. This type of cervical mucus is highly conducive to sperm survival and motility, making it easier for sperm to travel through the cervix and into the uterus. Many women use various methods to predict ovulation, such as monitoring basal body temperature, tracking changes in cervical mucus, or using ovulation prediction kits that detect the surge in luteinizing hormone. These methods can help individuals trying to conceive identify their most fertile days. It's important to note that the egg is viable for fertilization for a relatively short period, usually around 12 to 24 hours after release. Sperm, on the other hand, can survive in the female reproductive tract for several days. Therefore, the days leading up to ovulation are also considered fertile. The luteal phase is the second half of the menstrual cycle, following the follicular phase and ovulation. It is a crucial stage that prepares the female body for a potential pregnancy. This phase typically lasts for about 12 to 16 days, but the exact duration can vary among individuals and may be influenced by various factors. After ovulation occurs, the ruptured follicle in the ovary transforms into a structure called the corpus luteum. The corpus luteum is responsible for producing the hormones progesterone and some estrogen. Progesterone, in particular, plays a central role in the luteal phase. Under the influence of progesterone, the endometrium thickens, becomes more vascularized, and develops glands that can nourish a fertilized egg. If fertilization occurs and a successful pregnancy is established, the degeneration of the corpus luteum is prevented by the release of human chorionic gonadotropin, abbreviated as HCG, from the developing placenta. This is the hormone pregnancy test detect. This hormone signals the corpus luteum to continue producing progesterone, ensuring the stability of the pregnancy. If pregnancy does not occur, the corpus luteum will gradually disintegrate, causing a decrease in progesterone and estrogen levels. This hormonal shift signals the body to shed the thickened uterine lining, leading to the start of menstruation. The first day of menstrual bleeding marks the beginning of a new menstrual cycle. Some women may experience physical and emotional symptoms during the luteal phase. These symptoms are often collectively referred to as premenstrual syndrome and can include breast tenderness, bloating, mood swings, irritability, and fatigue. For some individuals, these symptoms can be quite severe and are known as premenstrual dysphoric disorder. The menstrual cycle is a complex, highly regulated physiological process that can be influenced by various factors. These factors can affect the regularity, length, and symptoms of the menstrual cycle. Hormones play a central role in regulating the menstrual cycle. Any imbalances in hormones, such as estrogen, progesterone, follicle-stimulating hormone, and luteinizing hormone, can lead to irregularities. Conditions like polycystic ovary syndrome, thyroid disorders, and hormonal medications can disrupt hormonal balance. High levels of stress can affect the hypothalamus, a region of the brain that controls hormone production. Stress can lead to irregular periods, missed periods, or changes in the length and intensity of the menstrual cycle. Chronic stress may also contribute to conditions like amenorrhea. Extreme changes in body weight, such as rapid weight loss or excessive exercise, can impact the menstrual cycle. Low body weight can lead to amenorrhea, while obesity can contribute to irregular periods. Proper nutrition and a healthy body weight are important for maintaining regular menstrual cycles. Age-related factors significantly influence the menstrual cycle. Girls typically start menstruating between ages 9 and 16, while menopause, the cessation of menstruation, typically occurs around age 45 to 55. Irregular periods can be common during adolescence and perimenopause. Certain medical conditions can affect the menstrual cycle. Conditions such as endometriosis, uterine fibroids, and pelvic inflammatory disease can lead to heavy or painful periods. Additionally, chronic illnesses, like diabetes or celiac disease, can influence menstrual regularity. Some medications, including anticoagulants, antipsychotics, and certain antihypertensive drugs, can impact the menstrual cycle. It's essential to consult a healthcare provider if you suspect your medications are affecting your periods. Frequent long-distance travel and shifts in time zones can disrupt the body's internal clock and, subsequently, the menstrual cycle. This is commonly referred to as traveler's amenorrhea. Exposure to environmental toxins, such as endocrine-disrupting chemicals, can potentially interfere with hormonal regulation and disrupt the menstrual cycle. Different forms of contraception, like birth control pills, hormonal intrauterine devices, or injections, can affect the menstrual cycle. Some methods may lead to lighter periods, while others can cause spotting or irregular bleeding. Emotional and psychological factors, such as anxiety, depression, or trauma, can impact the menstrual cycle. Stress, in particular, can disrupt hormone levels and lead to cycle irregularities. Smoking and substance abuse can have adverse effects on hormonal balance and may lead to menstrual irregularities or amenorrhea. Pregnancy and breastfeeding can lead to the cessation of menstruation. After childbirth, the return of regular periods varies among individuals. And that's all for this video. We hope you found this video informative and helpful in understanding the menstrual cycle better. This is just the beginning of our series on reproductive health. In our next video, we'll look at the process of fertilization and implantation. Stay tuned, subscribe to our channel, and hit that notification bell to be the first to know when the next video drops. Until then, take care and be well.